flange commands. In ZW3D 2016, much improvement has been made on flange functions, including new extrude flange for open and closed profiles, improved partial flange, and the new flex flange feature. Take this first case. Clicking the extrude flange command, we are then going to create a new sketch as input. After entering the sketch level, create an open sketch and define it the same as shown. Then exit the sketch. Back to the extrude flange command, set up the extrude length. And then keep on going to set up the thickness and the bend radius for the flange as follows. Done. Then unfold it. Choose one face as the stationary since we don't want to use the default plane. And then fold it again. Next, let's take a look at the improved partial flange command. Choose the edge to create a partial flange, and then change the flange's position with the position type, and then set up other parameters like the bend type, relief, and so on. Then we can change the direction of it, and change the start and end distances. Once done, go on to create another on the opposite side. Next, create a sketch on the right side as follows. Then click the Extrude tab command and pick the Merge with Base option. Now this tab has been added to the base as an integrated sheet metal. Extruded flange also supports closed profile. First, create a closed profile like sketch or so on. And then choose the extrude flange command. Pick the profile as input. Set up parameters like thickness, bend radius, direction, and others like it. Then we can also rip it as an opened flange. Next, unfold it and then fold it again. Last is the new swept flange. We will create a flange along several continuous edges. Firstly, choose the stationary face. And then create a sketch. Insert a new plane at the end point of the edges like so. Next, create a sketch based on the plan, then exit the sketch and go back to the swept flange command, and then pick the edge as a path from the chain edge. Set up the bend position and radius. Here we get this result.